It is like a man engaged in a desperate duel who keeps on trying to make it a game of cricket. Most of these soldiers detest every sort of mechanical device. The tanks, for example, which used with imagination might have given the British and French overwhelming victory on the Western Front, were subordinated to the usual cavalry breakthrough idea. I am not making any particular complaint against the British and French generals in saying this. It is what must happen to any country which entrusts its welfare to soldiers. A soldier has to be a severely disciplined man, and a severely disciplined man cannot be a versatile man, and on the whole, the British Army has been as receptive to novelties as any. The German generals have done no better. Indeed, they have not done so well as the generals of the Allies in this respect. But after the war, if the world does not organize rapidly for peace, then as resources accumulate a little, the mechanical genius will get to work on the possibilities of these ideas that have been merely sketched out in this war. We shall get big land ironclads which will smash towns. We shall get air offensives. Let the experienced London reader think of an air raid going on hour after hour, day after day, that will really burn out and wreck towns, that will drive people mad by the thousand. We shall get a very complete cessation of sea transit. Even land transit may be enormously hampered by aerial attack. I doubt if any sort of social order will really be able to stand the strain of a fully worked out modern war. We have still, of course, to feel the full shock effects of even this war. Most of the combatants are going on, as sometimes men who have incurred grave wounds will still go on for a time without feeling them. The educational, biological, social, economic punishment that has already been taken by each of the European countries is, I feel, very much greater than we yet realize. Russia, the heaviest and worst-trained combatant, has indeed shown the effects and is down and sick. But in 3 years' time, all Europe will know far better than it does now the full price of this war. And the shock effects of the next war will have much the same relation to the shock effects of this as the shock of breaking a fingernail to the shock of crushing in a body.